Preliminary reports indicate that 18 people have died in the accident. Three people who survived the accident were rushed to Kagadi Hospital for treatment. The incident happened near Muzizi Bridge on the Kagadi-Chenjojo Road after a trailer carrying silverfish rammed into a minibus. John Male, the Nyanseke LC1 chairperson, says the deceased are yet to be identified. Relatives will be notified to claim for the bodies from Kagadi Hospital's mortuary once this is done. The vehicle lost control and knocked the parked vehicle. The government needs to do something about all these accidents. We are getting finished. Please help us. Our people are getting finished.
Because of all this incident, it is as a result that when Yunda was working on this road, he didn't put into consideration this sharp corner, which was previously here. Remember when we still had Maram Road, we had two roads. There was this sharp corner, there was a road in the left and a road in the right, and in between, there was that kind of a heap dividing the two roads. We expected during the tarmac that these two roads would be provided for. Unfortunately, it was not.
Eyewitnesses attributed the accident to narrowness of the road. The driver lost control on the road and swerved and hit the stationary vehicle. The problem was the parked car. These big vehicles do not brake easily.
Beginning from, we need another keep left that connects to Muzizi, so that this becomes one way going up, so that there is another way going down. Otherwise, if that is not done, there is no way we can prevent incidents of such on this spot of the road.
By press time, relatives of the deceased had begun to flock Kagadi Hospital mortuary to claim the bodies.
Be vigilant. We must be careful whenever we intend to overtake. Let us overtake when we must, and let us be mindful of the oncoming vehicles and on other vehicles which are also trying to overtake.
Angry residents protested the narrow road that they say caused the accident, putting logs on the road. The police were called and fired tear gas to disperse them. Report by Andrew Musinguzi for the news.